All right, so let's get started accessing the source code that you need to work on the MP. Now, at this point, I'm assuming that you've installed Android Studio and Git and the other tools that you need to use. So the first step here is really to follow these instructions that are linked off of the lesson page. Now, this might be the most difficult part of today's lesson for you and getting started, and that's fine. Installing software can be tricky. There's mistakes that happen along the way and things like that. But this is the first thing to do. The course staff will also be there to help with this step of the process. And this is something where you can ask on the forum, you can ask on the help site, you can ask other students for help. There's no plagiarizing getting this stuff installed. We just want everybody to have it working so that you can work on the MP. This is also a good part of the assignment to work on with a partner if you've decided to collaborate on the MP, because you'll be able to help each other when you get stuck. But the instructions are also a little different depending on which machine you're working on, and so we're not going to go over those in detail. We're just going to let you follow these instructions. However, I will point out that Android Studio has excellent installation instructions. This is a commonly used software package. It's not like a weird thing. Millions of people use it all over the world to develop apps for Android. Android, despite things in the United States where iOS is quite popular, mainly because iOS devices are really expensive, Android is by far the most dominant smartphone platform on Earth. There are billions of devices all over the world that run Android, including in parts of the world where people can't or don't want to buy Apple products. So this is really, you know, in terms of increasing your reach, giving you global scope and impact, learning how to build Android apps is a great way to do that. And you know enough to get started. Now, there are going to be some bits and pieces of this that are going to be daunting. I don't want to minimize that. There's going to be some times where you're going to look at the code and be like, what is going on here? And you'll see bits and pieces that you'll recognize and other bits and pieces that you won't. That's okay. That's what it's like working on any big software project. And someday you will probably be working with others on a big project, and you'll sit down and you'll have a lot of code to go through, and it'll be a familiar experience at that point. But you'll know, I can do this, right? And you do it the same way that we always do, one step at a time, one line at a time. Ask questions, ask for help. We're there to support you. All right, so what we're going to do now, if you're watching this, if you don't have Android Studio installed, if you don't have Git installed, please go through our installation instructions and finish that step first. If you need help, you know, ask on the forum. What I'm going to do is walk you through the process of acquiring the starter code from GitHub. So you do need a GitHub account. I already have one, so this is going to take me to my profile page. If you don't have a GitHub account, you can create one. It's free. You don't have to associate it with your @Illinois email address. You can use any email address you want. Doesn't matter. We don't care. If you have a GitHub account already, you're welcome to use that. But this is an account on github.com. I also want to make that clear. There are a variety of university-run GitHub instances. We're not using that. This is the official, actual github.com that we're going to use, using a tool called GitHub Classroom. Once you have that GitHub account, you're going to click on this GitHub Classroom link, and I'm going to walk you through what happened here. So I've already accepted this, and it turned out that in order to record this demo, I went and deleted my repository. So I can re-accept, right? So I hit re-accept, and now it takes me to what you will arrive at the first time, which is this acceptance dialog, right? It says accept the assignment. This is the Java MP for this fall. This is what you want. Now, you can work on both Java and Kotlin on the MP. There's different repositories. The lessons will be different, but overall the learning objectives are identical. But I would suggest that you work in your primary language. So I'm going to accept the assignment. And now you get to this page. This page you actually have to refresh manually. I think sometimes people get confused here. It says refresh the page to see any updates. So I'm actually going to have to hit, Control R. Now it says the clone is done, and I'm going to click on this. And this is going to take me to my copy on github.com of our MP source code, right? And you can see there's a small README, and there's a bunch of code in here that we are going to explore together. So that's the first step, is to get to this point, right? Once you're at this point, you have Android Studio installed, Git installed, then you're ready to move on and actually import the code into Android Studio and start going through some of the basic steps. And that's what we'll cover next.